Good morning, and welcome to this week's virtual Sunday service, broadcasting live from Unity Church of the Hills in Austin, Texas. If you're watching, please let us know in the comments below so that we can say hello. We'd love to hear from you. We also encourage you to give this video a share, as it not only helps this video get distributed better to our own community, but you never know, the message of which might be just the very thing someone new needs to hear. If you'd like to learn more about our church, this service, or any other information during the live stream, don't be shy in the chat. Comment with the word connect anytime and someone will get in touch with you. My name is Lex Land, and I'm a member of the UCOH vocal group Celebration. And we as a music team decided it'd be fun to each personally check in with you and catch you up on what we've been up to since we've been apart. So last week you got to hear from Roderick about his summer vacation, and I'm afraid my time sheltered up hasn't been quite so glamorous, but it has been productive. Since I'm a full-time performing musician and venues everywhere are closed, I've been cooped up, but I somehow always manage to stay busy. Too busy. Since 2018, I've had a recurring morning music show on Facebook Live, and since things shut down, I've continued to do that. It's a fun and easy way for me to support my community and hopefully provide a little levity to listeners while they're stuck at home. Something else that keeps me busy year-round is my monthly membership platform, where I write, record, and exclusively release a brand new original song every month to my patrons over at Patreon. It's extra fun because the songs include a phrase sourced from my patrons too. Then, each summer, I put this production on hyperdrive and attempt to generate a brand new song each day for a whole week, an annual challenge I call 7 Songs in 7 Days. This year's 7 Songs in 7 Days starts tomorrow, so if you'd like to see if I can make it, or if you'd like to see an idea of yours turned into a song, now would be the perfect time to join us. Patrons get tons of exclusive content in addition to each monthly song, including all the music I've written and recorded since we started back in 2016. It takes less than 2 minutes to sign up. Tiers start as low as $1 a month, and memberships are cancelable and refundable if you try it out for a month and find that it's not your thing. Sponsorships, of course, help keep me and my music business afloat, but it's also a fun and interactive way to create some good stuff for the world together. You can easily find me at the Lex Land Facebook page or email me anytime at lex@lexlandmusic.com. If you'd like to participate or have any questions, I'd be happy to assist. Again, welcome to Unity Church of the Hills for this week's virtual service. Please let us know in the comments that you're watching with us and where you're watching from. Give this post a share to help us spread the video. And lastly, type the word connect anytime in the chat if you have any questions. We're here for you. Enjoy the service and the rest of your weekend, and I hope this finds you happy and well.
Ooh. good morning, Unity Church of the Hills. So glad that you are here with us today. Fabulous music celebration. Love that. Can go to God in prayer right now. That's right. Hey, just want to thank you for joining us online today and all the different platforms. And, you know, it's a delightful day because I have pictures of all of you right in front of me now. So it feels like you're right in the room. So, again, thanks for joining us, and thanks for supporting Unity Church of the Hills through your contributions, your tithes, your gifts. During this time of being apart, it is so important for us to connect online in all the different ways that we have found to be a spiritual community, so thank you for supporting us through this time. And also, our vision statement's going to be coming up right behind me here, and I just invite you to join me in saying these words out loud together wherever you are this morning. Our vision: we are an ever-expanding community of love and acceptance where lives are transformed. So what a joy it is, and of course, if you are joining us for the first time today, welcome. Unity is a positive path for spiritual living that honors all paths to God. As my good friend Dr. Lloyd Barrett used to say, all paths lead to the mountaintop. So let us join hands and walk that path together. So wherever you are on your spiritual path, we will meet you right where you are. And of course, if you want to know more about this wonderful place called Unity Church of the Hills, just type in connect and an ambassador will reach out to you. So as Celebration sang, I now invite you to join me in our opening prayer. So if it's comfortable where you are and you're not driving, go ahead and close your eyes and go within and allow yourself to feel and sense into that divine presence of the living Spirit, that which lives, breathes, and has its very being through each of us. Wherever we are and whatever life we are living, I know that we are living, breathing expressions of the divine Spirit, that we are connected at the very core of our being with that divinity that we are absolutely born with. It is our birthright. From the very first breath we take, we are connected and we are whole. And so I celebrate this day, this time that we have dedicated to being together in spirit, being together in community, online, in person, all the different ways that we have found to stay connected with the divine energy. And so I know this day, as we join together in this celebration service, that we are blessed with a new understanding of that journey of wholeness, to maybe forgetting our wholeness, to remembering that wholeness within each one of us. So I give thanks for this service. We are blessed by the music, by the meditation, by the inspiring message and prayers, so that this day we are blessed with an unfolding of our life and an even greater life yet to be. I give thanks for all of this and know that we are absolutely blessed, and it is that Christ Spirit that lives within each one of us that I dedicate this prayer. And I know it is so, and so I let it be, and so it is. Amen.
Good morning, spiritual family. If you're enjoying today's service, please take a moment to like it and share it with your friends. As Lex reminded us in her opening video, you never know. Today's message may be exactly what someone needs to hear. And if you're inspired throughout the service, please let us know. Emojis and comments are welcome. We're so grateful for our praying chaplains who are holding space virtually for us today. To receive prayer support from one of these beautiful souls following the service, please call 512-814-5365. Leave a message with your name, phone number, and a request, and a chaplain will call you back. Are you eating enough fruits and vegetables? If not, you'd better catch up. Yep, it's a bad tomato joke. People, we have a lot of tomatoes, and they are available at our bookstore on a love offering basis. If you've had a chance to stop by the bookstore for vegetables, please comment with your favorite vegetable emoji. And if you want the bad tomato jokes to end, please stop by the bookstore and help us support our community garden. Okay, so that last announcement, it was a stretch. And speaking of stretching, we have online yoga. So Donna Pinnell leads a Monday morning class at 10 a.m., and Shin's class is on Fridays at 2 p.m. Both are offered on a love offering basis. Please visit unityhills.org for more details. Our We Wisdom fall registration is now open for 2, 3, and half-day programs. We Wisdom preschool uses a blend of both Montessori and traditional child development approaches to ensure that each child's needs are met in a loving, supportive spiritual environment. Please contact Director Carrie Monk at carrie.monk@unityhills.org if you're interested in enrolling, taking a tour, or have any questions. I am so excited to announce that we are supporting Round Rock ISD Families in Transition with a school supply drive. Families in Transition exists to ensure that children in homeless situations have the opportunities and tools necessary to succeed in school. Whether or not schools are meeting in person, these tools are essential for our students to be successful. And we want to do everything that we can to support these students during this time. The drive runs through August 7th, and you can learn more and contribute by visiting unityhills.org. On Tuesday, we sent an email asking for candidate recommendations to serve on our Board of Trustees, beginning later this year. In November, at our annual meeting, we'll be electing 3 board members to each serve a 3-year term. The nominating team is looking for your input on church members who seek to live Unity principles, are actively involved in UCOH, and possess the leadership skills necessary to serve. If that describes you or someone you know, please visit unityhills.org to make your recommendation today. You can stay up to date on all that's happening here at Unity Church of the Hills by liking our Facebook page, subscribing to our newsletter, and downloading our UCOH app. And now I invite you, as we shift into meditation, to gently close your outer eyes. Place your left hand over your heart and do so as you would place your hand on an infant's back, out of love and to be a stabilizing, steady support with a kind and compassionate heart. This is a time for you to deeply nurture your soul, to drink in and send out love. And so I invite you to relax into the rhythm of your breath, in and out, soft and gentle, as you connect with that foundation of your being that is unchangeable, unconditional love, formed as wholeness itself in the very beginning. Can you feel it? Give yourself permission to connect, to be that love for yourself, because this is who and whose you are. A divine spark having chosen to come from formlessness to express in this world of matter and form. And the form that you choose has changed and will change. It wears personas and beliefs like layers of clothes. But it is not you. So I invite you to drop beneath the layers to the changeless, whole, essential essence of your being. Beneath the thoughts, beneath the stories, to the essence of love that you are, to the divine expression of the one life. As you breathe and notice in the silence. Allow the emanation of love that you are to fill the room that you are in, to go beyond the borders of your skin, to be that one life. And let that truth of you dissolve away all sense of separation. As you bring yourself back into this time and space, toes and toes, that changeless nature of your being is who you are. Be that in the world today. And when you are ready, open your beautiful eyes.
Given me an earthly home with family.
I am a child of God. You know, I'm pretty sure the way it was resonating in my heart, that song, that's what we hear as we're birthing into this life. It's such a great welcoming to this life and the possibilities of it. Thank you. You know, my talk title today is The Inner Evolution, A Journey of Wholeness. As I followed my heart and decided that I would give it a shot to speak about something I've been doing for 25 years, and that is the inner child journey. And as I was talking with Tammy earlier today, it was challenging because I have about 25 hours of material that I'm going to speak to over the next 20 minutes, so I better get on with it. But my favorite saying from the master teacher Jesus is from Matthew chapter 18, verse 3, where he says, "Truly I say unto you, unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven." Of course, we know that Jesus wasn't talking about some far-off place. In New Thought, we realize that heaven is available to us right here, right now. We don't have to wait till we go through a transition into some other life experience. And I believe he was talking about, when he was talking about becoming like a little child, it was becoming that childlike innocence, that wonder, that awe, that creativity and imagination. So I believe, as many New Thought writers and teachers have said, that we are born of an original blessing, not an original sin. And that that blessing is our birthright at our first breath. You know, one of my favorite stories is of this young couple who had a 2-year-old son who wanted to say hello to the newborn baby in their family. But he wanted to be alone with this little baby, and it took the parents a little while. They were, you know, must have read too many books about sibling rivalry or something, but they finally agreed to let little Joey go in the room and talk to his baby brother. But they wanted to make sure everything would be okay, so they left the door open just a little bit. So here Joey goes in, and he leans into the crib where his baby brother was just being by himself, and he leans in, and this is what they heard. "Tell me about God. I'm already beginning to forget. Tell me about God. I'm already beginning to forget." You know, this morning I want to talk about this journey of wholeness because we are whole. It's the very basis of what Charles Myrtle Fillmore and Emma Curtis Hopkins and Ernest Holmes all spoke to. That spiritual mind treatment, prayer, affirmative prayer, is always based on the wholeness that lives within us. There is an imprint of perfection that we can tap into. So the whole journey of life is about wholeness. So what's interesting about the journey is where this original blessing, and then we have a period of forgetting, seems to start pretty early. And then, hopefully, there's a time of remembering. I know for me, the remembering part was a little later in life, later than I might have wanted it. But here's what I know today, is that we are whole children of a loving God, and that it is through connecting with that inner child part of us that we can begin the pathway of remembering our wholeness. You know, so the first thing is to talk about the inner child. You know, does everybody have one? Yes. In 1987, I was early in my recovery, and I went to a recovery weekend workshop with John Bradshaw in Colorado Springs. John is known for a lot of his books that were written about the inner child, that part of us. And of course, as a skeptical person, I wanted to know, just where did that inner child live? How can you spot him? And so I've got a couple of clues for you. Just what you need to know is that inner child was just as much a part of you and is now as ever has been. What's interesting about the inner child is they make a lot of decisions. Some psychologists say by the age of 7, we have decided how we're going to show up in life. And these decisions are made, and we live from these decisions throughout our life until we become conscious of them. You know, what's interesting is our inner child may have decided that we were creative, or that we could sing, or maybe they heard that they'll never be enough. Or maybe they were told to just mouth the words in the choir. You know, nobody really needs to hear your voice. Or maybe from Sunday school, I remember this one, that it is easier for a camel to get through the eye of a needle than a rich man to get into heaven. Now, you suppose that would bring up any issues through your life? Probably not. Probably not, but these are just some cues for how you spot the inner child. And what's interesting about some of these life decisions is they may still be going on in your life today. You know, when somebody gets very upset, you know, they've often been triggered by something that inner child within you was touched by at a very early age. It may feel like what's going on between us right now, some anger or frustration or whatever, has nothing to do with me. It might have a lot to do with you and your growing up. You know, I'm going to give you a tool that is pretty easy to do, and you can do this in the comfort of your own home at your own leisure. You don't have to get up right now and get a piece of paper, but later on, I invite you to get out a piece of paper and draw a picture of that inner child, maybe, you know, at 6 or 7. And you don't have to worry about anybody else seeing this, unless there's somebody in your house and you just tell them to back off. But, you know, draw the picture of this child that you were. And then I want you to take another piece of paper. And this is the one that usually challenges people, but it's so important. Is I would like you to write a message from this child within in your less dominant hand. There's something about writing with your less dominant hand that stops the mental process of trying to figure it out. This is an opportunity to allow that which lives within you to begin to speak to you. The next piece I want to talk about is how we're born in this wholeness, but then there is a birth of separation. You know, this birth of separation happens in a lot of different ways. And it starts early. You know, we heard Joey and asking his baby brother to tell him about God because he's already starting to forget. But you know what? I was delighted when I learned that a member of Unity Church of the Hills, Lillian Deschardin, wrote a book called The Imprint Journey. I just got it at our bookstore. There's a couple more copies left. But I've been reading, and it's so in the same vein as The Inner Child Journey. And she talks about how, I would call it a birth of separation, but these were ideas that were imprinting on her, ideas that she was going to live part of her life by. And some of them were like these. God was against us. I can't tell you how many people during the course of an inner child journey have told me that the God that they were brought up with was an angry, spiteful God, or a moody God, or a Santa Claus God, keeping a list and checking it twice, see if you've been naughty or nice. But you know, that's what she said. God was against us. And then another area, she said, as the communists said, and this at a very young age, she was like 4 or 5, that God didn't even exist. I mean, that really gets a person's mind working, right? And she said her best solution was to deny the inner conflict and to pretend it wasn't there. We have a concept in the inner child journey called acting as if. And it starts at a very young age because we begin to act the way we think we need to for you to love me. We start acting a certain way so that I'll be accepted. We start acting a certain way so that I'll be loved. Well, here's the sad part. Is this can continue until we become aware of this process, this imprinting, so that we can begin to act that way as adults in our relationships, everywhere we go. There's a little thing Dr. Roger calls people roaming with a sense of pissosity. I like to call it pissed off waiting to happen. I think we got a little bit of that going on right now. There are some triggers that are happening in our world that are creating rage and anger and upset and dissonance that have triggered old memories, new sadness, you know, some separation. You know, she goes on to talk about how her parents were imprinted with scarcity and not enoughness. Not enoughness. That's the most common decision that I've seen most inner child have made, that I'm not enough and I'll never be enough. You know, I too was the son of an adult child of an alcoholic whose father died of alcoholism at age 46. My dad wasn't ready to see the bad information he was given, and so he generously passed on to us the messages of his childhood, one of which was not enough. And, of course, a moody God, got that one, scarcity, and that we would all have to work hard just to stay ahead. These are the messages that create that birth of separation from what we are born with, the sense of an original blessing that we are. Well, there's good news. Big good news. We can shift our awareness. A lot of it happens because we become aware that this has been going on, that some of the decisions we made as children, trust me, many of them were great decisions that helped protect us and may have even saved our lives in some cases. Don't talk to Daddy when he's drunk. These are good messages, you know. For some people, that was survival, to get out of this family alive. But once we recognize that we made some erroneous decisions or we're still living from them, then we can start to make a change. I'm sure you've heard in unity circles, change your mind and change your life, change your thinking, change your life. That's absolutely true. It is that simple. If I ever write a book, it'll be about change, one thought at a time. Because I believe that's exactly how it happens, is one thought at a time. More good news. We share in the inner child journey that there is an invisible power that you can use. The only requirement is you need to become aware of it because you've been using it all your life. That's what I loved when I stepped into a New Thought church. I suddenly realized, you know, I came from a background as an architect, so I had no problem visualizing and knowing that I could create from nothingness. But what I learned is that I've been doing this all my life. And you know, it's great in unity. The third principle, we co-create with God. It's the same in all New Thought teachings. We are co-creators with God through our thoughts, our beliefs, our feelings, our attitudes, our thoughts moment by moment by moment. So, you know, at first I was a little paranoid because I thought, oh my God, I'm not going to create from every thought, am I? Well, no, that's not the way it works. What's true is the thoughts that have your feeling, your passion, those are the ones that show up. If you flippantly say something, thank goodness, because I do, in just passing, it may not have any roots in passion or intent, but it'd still be good to be mindful. So how do we spot decisions that no longer work for us? Well, by now, I'm hoping that you are already hearing some of the messages from your own childhood. Not that they're guiding your life, but you're becoming aware of them because the awareness is the key to the transformation. That's the evolution. You know, I'm aware that two of our prayer chaplains, Joni and John, are working on a piece called Conscious Conversations. I just heard this morning that they're looking at doing a workshop. This will be valuable because conscious conversations are what it takes to take something that isn't known into the known so that we can do something with it. We can heal the old script, the old imprint. So some of the message from your own childhood, besides not enough, or maybe you don't trust God, you might have heard you can't trust men, or you can't trust women, or you can't trust a minister, or a priest, or a nun, or whatever. There's a lot of reasons why that has happened. There's been a lot of healing, but I'm sure there's more to happen. Maybe you heard you can't trust yourself, or you can't trust anybody. I was told I can't go to any other church or I'm going to go to hell. Well, I didn't. Maybe you heard that you'll never amount to anything. Or maybe you heard you can't sing, or you heard that you aren't creative, and the list goes on and on and on. We do an exercise in the inner child journey to give you an opportunity to see what's acceptable and what's not acceptable. Well, that's a confusing list. Often you see that some things are on the inner circle. The same thing is out here. It's not acceptable. All right. Well, that's a perfect message, isn't it? Well, all of these, between the messages, what's acceptable and unacceptable, create what we call a weave. It's like this. It's like if I was going to talk to you from only through my weave, you would get a lot of my things that have blocked me all my life. But what's great about doing this work, whether it's the inner child journey or some of the classes or maybe conscious conversations, is you get more and more space in the weave. Till finally, you've let the weave go. And I can show up as my unique, individualized expression of God that I was born with at the very first breath. The way out, there is a way out. You're not going to like this one. It's to fully feel all the messages that you've been given. Sometimes it's very painful. A lot of times there's a lot of tears. Because remember, it's the inner child. They felt them. And they stifled themselves so they would act in the way that they would at least feel a little love. Why do people stay in very damaging relationships? It's because they're too afraid to risk. What if nobody loves me? You know, that kind of thing. But the good news is repressed feelings can be released. We go through a process where people go through that energy. It's, you know, feelings are energy. The same energy that is so creative in Unity Principle 3, where we co-create with God or in a spiritual mind treatment, is the energy that's holding us back. And guess what? Repressed energy then, this is the bad news, shows up in our body. You ever had a lower back thing going on? Maybe intestines or in the shoulders or a lot of headaches. I've witnessed this. I've experienced it myself. And I have watched people, after a 2 or 3 day workshop, walk out. And it's like with all these, you know, frowns and, you know, tight faces and all that. But they walk out and they're like, they look different. It's like they're not holding those feelings back anymore. And, you know, just don't go share your feelings with everybody. Find the right people, right? Do that in a safe place. Not everybody actually wants you to feel all over them. But, you know, people are walking taller. They're feeling more joy. They're feeling the possibilities of that individualized expression of life that they were born to be. So this is the evolution of wholeness to wholeness. Born as a child of God, always a child of God, but maybe forgotten. Maybe forgotten the creativity or the imagination because we're taught those lack, limitation, prejudice, scarcity, but all of that can be eliminated. All of it can be let go of. It does take a courageous conversation. It's a process of remembering and becoming the parent of your inner child, the one that is most equipped to be the parent of your inner child is you. So we give you tools, you know, to how to be with your inner child. I was noticing this morning as I woke up, because I was getting ready to this, I'm very in tune with my inner child, and he was like, call on me, call on me. And I thought, you know, my inner child was very excited to be retired. You know, we could go to the beach, we could go play, we'd go to Disney World. We were some of the last people in Disney World and some of the last people on Galveston Island Beach. But here's why coming to Unity Church of the Hills for 6 months was okay. It's because my inner child, who grew up camping with my family in the Boundary Waters canoe area in northern Minnesota, gets to camp the whole time he's here. I'm in my RV. I get to camp for the whole time. So my inner child's fine. It's like, we'll get back. They closed Disney anyway. So we'll get back to that. I've brought my whole staff of the inner child journey to Disneyland before. And there's nothing like taking a group of people who know how to act like a 10-year-old and run from ride to ride. I've actually gone to Disneyland by myself, spent the whole day from 8 a.m. to whatever, midnight or something, and I am running from ride to ride just like all the other 10-year-olds. And it's always a joy. And I always pause around 2 o'clock to pray for the parents who are having a meltdown with their children because they didn't take a break. It's like, really? Take a break. So I want to just leave you with this. You know, I have just given you a view through a knothole in the fence. Hopefully some of this has excited you to the possibility of doing this work. I've talked to Dr. Roger. I was actually on staff for the first inner child journey that Dr. Roger and his wife, Erica, took. And so when he hired me, he knew that I could facilitate the inner child journey. So we were just bantering back and forth. And we both agreed. We think we can do this. By we, I mean me. I think I can create an experience of the inner child workshop in a Zoom platform workshop where you can do the work, you know, at home, the safety of your home, and you can still have a very rich and powerful experience. So I am going to be working on that. It's going to take me a little bit of time, but I'll keep you posted. But I want to leave you with this. Vincent van Gogh, I love what he said. He said, if you ever hear a voice within you saying, you are not a painter, then by all means, paint, and that voice will be silenced. So let the inner child within you sing, paint, dance, and be who you've come here to be. I invite you now to just join me in prayer. And as I move to prayer, I just want to invite us to send our love, our blessings, our loving embrace to the family of Representative John Lewis, who just made his transition recently at the age of 80, living an incredible life, making an amazing difference in the history of the United States, and in particular, in civil rights and in African-American lives. I send my love, my loving embrace to you, John, for I know where you are in this moment is a perfect place, this next dimension of life, and I give thanks for all that you have given us. And so now I just open up to the possibilities and the life, the expansive life of that divine presence, that living presence that has absolutely breathed life into each one of us. I give thanks for that. I know that we are living, breathing expressions of the divine spirit. We have always been that, and we are more that now than ever before. This moment, whoever may be listening to these words, this prayer, that right where you are, the difference you have been born in the world to make is already percolating and yearning to be expressed. That imagination, that inner child within you is letting you know in this moment how they want to be in the world, how they want to express the joy, the laughter, the love, the jokes, the play. All of those things are now coming into possibility in everyone's lives. I give thanks for this, and I send these words to that Christ Spirit that lives and expresses itself through each one of us. It is in that name that I speak these words, knowing that it is already done. And so I let it go and let it be, and so it is. I just get excited about this stuff. So now is the time in our service where we get to support our spiritual community and practice the law of circulation during this key time in the history of Unity Church of the Hills. Note, the Board of Trustees and our Board President, Frank, asked me if I would share with you that in June, we saw a dip in our income, our June income, and we can foresee some issues down the road. But as Frank told me, the community has expressed a desire to know if we come to that bridge on the road, so I'm letting you know. That's a possibility that lay before us. But if you're willing to keep your giving steady, or even some of you may have the ability to add a little bit more to your giving if you're able, that'd be okay. But we'd rather tell you up front than later on. So thank you so much for all that you have given. And I just want you to know that the Board of Trustees, myself, our staff, our finance director, we will do everything in our power to ensure that we are spending these dollars in the most effective way possible. So, as you know, there's a number of ways to give. So you're going to see up on the screen, you can give through an app, text, online, or by mail. And just know that we are absolutely grateful for your generosity. And I forgot my giving envelope today. You to put that gift over your heart, if it's online or whatever it's going to be, but represent it by placing that gift over your heart and just infuse it with love. The energy of love that you have for this spiritual community and all the wondrous ways that it supports you now through this COVID crisis, but also it has throughout your life. And now let us speak our affirmation together. Blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I circulate, and I am grateful. And now, feel free to stand up right where you are, because this is an amazing song.
I've been ground so long and trying this stuff for years. I got none to show, just found this rope right here. Fumbling man upstairs with a woman bringing me rain. Cause I've been sending up prayers, everything's changed. I think I finally found my hallelujah. I've been waiting for this moment all my life. Now all my dreams are coming true. Live right about now.
I almost can't handle it. I could get you. alive right about now. Good, 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 good to be alive right about now. Good, 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 good to be alive right about now.
Right about now. All right. There it is. All right. All right. Well, if we were all together, I would see the kids dancing right up the aisle here with their teachers, and this is what we would say. Children, youth, angels, and behold the Christ you are, because it's a good life, and we're living it. So thank you again for your financial support. So grateful. It is the grease, the oil, the gasoline that keeps this engine running. So keep on sending that in, and of course, stick around for our Going Deeper, or as some people have come to know it, Stump the Minister. Following our prayer, say this with me, would you? The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever you are, God is, and all is well. Have a great Sunday. Thank you, Celebration. Thank you, Unity Church of the Hill staff. Have a blessed day. Take care. I just took an extra 4 minutes.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back for our Going Deeper. Very excited to see if we can stump the minister together. So if you have a question for Dr. Raz about his message, please go ahead and type that in the comments. And let's see if I've got any here. Not yet, but I have one for you. Okay. So some who are still have some trouble connecting with their inner child. Can you give us more ways to connect? Any other tools you might suggest?
You know, it's probably the most common question I've ever received is, how do I connect with my inner child? I don't get it.
Right.
You know, that sort of a thing.
Right.
You know, some of the things that are the most useful, especially for you personally, us personally,
yeah,
is, you know, I've recently been going through old pictures to get ready to move.
Yeah.
So pictures are a great reminder. Mm-hmm. You know, if you haven't thrown them all away yet, keep those, because we love getting those in the inner child journey. We actually ask you to bring them.
Oh, nice.
So in preparation for the Inner Child Journey Zoom, find some pictures. So pictures, if you have any old toys, and if you don't have old toys, which, by the way, would be worth a lot depending on how old you are. try to remember your best friends, you know, the school days, school experiences. Some people have, favorite foods from when they were a child. Moon pies, I think, right, were big in the South, right? some hot dishes will, because I come from Minnesota, don't you know? some hot dishes will bring back childhood memories. But I think that's really what it's about, is that inner part of you. This isn't like, some miniaturized version of you living inside your body. It's in every part of you. It's in your thoughts, your feelings, emotions, memories especially. So those are just some ways that I think could help.
Awesome. Thank you. Mm-hmm. I've got a question here. So you mentioned the idea that children decide how they will be by age 7. And that sounds so final. Is it difficult? Is this a difficult thing to reverse? What if a child you know is behaving in a way that seems they have made a poor decision? So it sounds like there's a two-part question there.
Yeah, when I was a kid, I would throw temper tantrums.
Me too.
I'm hoping I'm not doing that these days. But it was something I decided, because I'm fifth of six kids.
Oh, wow.
And I needed to get people's attention.
Right.
So it's something I decided to do. I think this isn't me that says that a lot of people make decisions that impact their life by the age of 7. It's actually psychological studies.
Right.
But the good news, if you missed that part, is we can change all of it. And I have.
Yeah.
The not enough, I didn't go into this because I have 25 hours of material, but the not enough decision is at the root of a lot of addiction.
Yeah.
If you've never heard me talk about addiction, one of the things that I often use, it's kind of a catchphrase for me, that if I'm feeling the urge to drink, I'll just say, nah, they don't have enough. Which mm-hmm. is good for me as a recovering alcoholic, but the other was one is too many and 27's not enough. So, there are things, and trust me, I wasn't drinking at 7, I waited till I was 13 before I started 25 years of drinking and drugging, but that's another talk for another day. So, don't give up. The truth is, some of the things, I would have never thought that I would become a minister as I looked at the first 38 years of my life, but I did, and I think I'm effective, and I don't throw temper tantrums, Tammy would be able to tell you. I'm pretty even-keeled kind of person.
Yes, you are.
But everything can be changed. Everything is up for review. Yeah. But if something, here's how we can spot decisions if it's no longer working for you. One of my favorite questions, and sometimes it kind of pisses people off, is how's that working for you? If it's not working, it was a decision you don't even remember making. And I shared some of those, how we interact with people, how we show up in a room. I actually am very shy, believe it or not.
I don't believe it.
Yeah. So, I didn't date until I was out of high school, never went to a prom. I was afraid of girls. And I had lots of relationships and broke up in those relationships, but the girls never knew it. So it's just funny. The things we do. So hopefully that helps.
I want to circle back to the second part of that question, because I imagine there are a lot of parents that are watching. So it's kind of like the flip side of it is, how can a parent today who's blessed to know New Thought show up to support a child before they get to that age of seven.
Sure.
Or, you know.
Well, there's good news and bad news. Kids, we all, make up our own minds no matter what upbringing you're brought up in. Because
yeah.
we make stuff up. Some of us have PhDs and MSU. we make stuff up.
Yeah.
You know, being one of six kids, sometimes when I talk to my siblings, it's like, what house did you grow up in?
Oh,
you know,
right.
we all make decisions or have experiences within our family that are even so different than what's being offered.
Yeah.
You know, my parents loved me. Now, they didn't know how to say it. But I realized during my own healing, I think it was the third time I said, I just don't like the way my dad shows me he loves me. And the facilitator finally said, so I never heard you say your dad doesn't love you. And it was just like a load of bricks. It was like, you're right. That was never the question.
Right.
He didn't know how to hug, and he didn't know how to say I love you. So I had to teach him.
Yeah.
I did not like having to do that. So you do the best you can. We have two boys. They're now men, 33 and 30. And, you know, everybody's got their work to do.
Right.
I don't think you get out of it. I think the human experience is a journey of wholeness. We get to experience it very young.
Yeah.
That's why it's a delight to be with my grandkids.
Yeah.
Because they don't have as much of the weave.
Yeah.
So I guess that's the biggest advice. Try not to give them too much weave.
Right.
You know? And you still need to discipline your children, teach them what you know. But pay attention to those little feelings of, wow, I just sounded like my dad. Well, just question that.
Right.
Was that a good piece to pass on, or am I passing on a family tradition that goes back generations?
So yeah, perfect.
It's a long answer, but I'm a minister. I'm full of those.
All right, so this next question. How can we differentiate between being playful and enjoying life from unhealthy, immature behavior?
You know what I have noticed is most people look at play as a four-letter word.
Yes.
And I'm going to ask everybody, when can you play? I already heard the answer. You don't even have to say it. You can't play until the work is done.
Right.
You know,
so
what's really big, I think, and I've talked to Tammy a little bit about this, I'm one of the few ministers I know that isn't a workaholic. I know how to play. I think that's because I learned how to play.
Yeah.
My wife, Tina, she has learned how to play by being around me because I know how to do it. So, playful, playing, all of those things aren't the same as immature, you know, the old, I mean, who wasn't asked, to act their age?
Right.
I always wanted to say to my dad, even when I was five, I am.
Right.
But I didn't want to get swatted, because that's back when you could still swat and not go to jail. So, you know, it is a dance, but I personally think being playful, seeing humor, imagination, creativity, those are healthy. Healthy, healthy, healthy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I love what Martha Graham once said. She said, great dancers are not great because of their technique. They are great because of their passion.
Mm.
You see, passion comes from the inner child. Imagination. People become more creative, more imagination, more accessing of those kinds of things. I am a huge Disney fan.
Mm-hmm.
I have watched, you know, Disney Imagineering on Disney Plus. At least, it only came out last fall. I bet I have watched it 12 times.
I'm gonna have to check it out.
Because I love how they create.
Yeah.
And I think it's because they have allowed their inner child to have a voice.
Yeah.
It should be part of the committee that decides how you're going to live your life. You know, I must admit, I'll just be honest, I didn't check with my inner child about this 6 months. Okay. I just noticed it today.
Yeah.
You know, but it's true. My inner child loves that we get to camp out for 6 months.
Oh, that's great.
You know, because I grew up with it, you know.
Yeah. So for those of us who find play a challenge, will the Inner Child Journey Workshop help us with that? Will it help us come to a better way of being playful?
Yeah, that's one of those areas I got to work with on a Zoom.
Right.
because we do a whole exercise on it, and what I know is it triggers some people.
Yeah.
Because a lot of adults do not know how to play. So I got to sit with that one, and I'm not sure.
Okay.
I know the Inner Child Journey has components for that. And trust me, that particular part of the Inner Child Journey pisses some people off. But only for a while, and then it transforms their lives.
Beautiful.
Because once you learn how to play, you'll want to include it.
Yeah.
You know, as the executive director at Mile High Church, I required people to take their vacation and not bring your laptop with, not work. You know, I don't even want to know it until you get back. And it was really hard for some people because they had banked, you know, weeks and weeks and weeks of vacation. As an HR person, I knew that was a bad idea. As somebody who loved my staff, I wanted them to live their life.
That's,
you know, do
beautiful.
Something that's fun.
Yeah.
You know, whatever that is. I know even now it's more challenging probably than ever, but I am determined to find a bike route tomorrow to go ride my bike somewhere.
Lovely. If you all have a good bike route,
yeah, send
for
it on
Raz,
in.
Comment in the comments here.
That's right.
I wanted to circle back around just because you mentioned Disney, and I think this is kind of a fun question from Courtney here. So how do you manage to run from ride to ride at Disney? And I actually wanted to know what was your favorite ride?
Well, how do you run? You know, I don't run as fast as I used to. But when I took a group from Mile High Church, it was so funny. For those of you that have ever watched a service, you know that Jennifer Burnett is our principal soloist and our artistic director. But her daughter, I think, was maybe 14 at the time. And she knew right off that we should follow Raz wherever he goes.
Yeah.
So they did. They tagged along. And I have lots of favorite rides, but I have new favorites. I was able to ride Rise of the Resistance at Disney World in Hollywood Studios. And I tell you, that is the best ride ever.
Oh, wow.
I mean, I have some old-time favorites, but one of them is going to be replaced, renewed, and released, and that is Splash Mountain.
Oh, yeah.
They've been using a very racist, they don't use Song of the South as a theme, but some of the characters are from that, and it's a very racist cartoon.
Oh, yeah.
So, but I celebrate Princess and the Frog. Let's bring it on. Let's see what it's like. And
awesome.
I've been to all the parks. We spent 10 days at Disney World in January.
Oh, how fun.
And we intend to go back in 22 when everything's open and everything is good again. So.
Awesome.
I've been to every Disneyland or Disney park in the world except Shanghai and Tokyo.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so we've been to Hong Kong, Paris, all
Disney
World.
I don't even know where they have them all.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Shanghai looks great. My son, you know, lived in China, so that's why we went to Hong Kong.
Perfect. Okay, so bringing it back to the Inner Child Journey, although that is related, what kind of healing do you think our congregation could expect to gain from doing the Inner Child Workshop?
You know, I talked with Dr. Roger about this, and I'm aware that some people have some healing to do around just the last 6, 8 months to a couple of years. And what I have noticed with inner child work is it's very instrumental in working with anything that has been triggered. What I notice about upset and anger and stuff that happens in churches or at your work or in your family, nothing is off limits because we bring our inner child wherever we go. So if something was hurt inside of you for the way the Grandins were let go of, and or something was hurt during the time when there was no minister, or something was hurt before. I mean, it doesn't matter when.
Right.
Churches are ripe with opportunities to heal. Why? Because we're people.
Yeah.
You know, and we go through stuff, and we bring. You know what I liken it to is we have some invisible baggage. And we've been carrying it around all our life. And wouldn't it be nice to not have to carry it around anymore?
Yes.
So anything really can be worked on and healed in an inner child journey. And that's my intention for the Zoom version of this, because forgiveness is a big part. I actually didn't get into that today because I thought I could do a whole talk just on forgiveness. So that might be next week.
Awesome.
Because forgiveness is the opening to freedom.
Yeah. Oh, there's your talk title.
There you go. Write that down.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Raz. Let me check. I don't see any more questions. So any final
thoughts? Okay, I want to end with a quote.
All right.
This is from Dr. Seuss. You know, some people have become ministers as a result of doing this inner child work.
Wow. All right.
I would be one of those. I was not looking for a church. But when I saw John Bradshaw, and he talked about the inner child and work of the inner child, I knew when a friend of mine said, hey, there's this religious science church. Yeah, you know, that was a buzzword
right.
for me. Church, God, Jesus, you know, all those kind of things. I got over it. I love Jesus. I love church. You know, and God's not bad either. But, you know, I had no idea that doing the inner child journey would open me up to remembering,
yep.
that at 8 years old, I wanted to be a priest. And for 25 years of my addiction, it took the addiction to keep that from surfacing. So, as Dr. Seuss's character Lorax said, unless someone likes you cares a whole awful lot, nothing is going to get better. It's not. So, you know, I love truth wherever it's spoken, whether it's Dr. Seuss or Ben and Jerry or Charles Fillmore. Yeah. You know, truth is everywhere. It's all around us. All we got to do is look.
Absolutely. All right.
Amen.
Well,
and
amen.
So it is.
Thank you guys so much for sticking around for the Going Deeper, and have a beautiful Sunday and a beautiful week. We love you.
Take care. Have a great week.